Okay.
Okay, we should be getting live here in a minute. I know. Okay. Okay, cool. Well, this is going to be going live. There's a little bit of a delay. We intentionally added that delay so that we could have a little bit higher quality content. But I'm Charlie from Daily Motor, and we are here with the live drive of the 2020 Hyundai Sonata Hybrid. We've got Alyssa behind the camera. She and I are going to be hopping back and forth and talking about the car and all that good stuff.
Heyo.
Taking turns driving and taking a look at Hyundai's beautiful new sedan, one that gets nearly 50 miles to the gallon in all sorts of driving situations. So, for those of you who have never tuned in before, this is a live drive. This is an opportunity for us to interact with those of you on the channel, answer any questions you might have either about the vehicle that we're driving or any of the cars we've had recently, cars we might have coming up soon, or just anything else you might want to chat about. So hit us up in the comments. Alyssa's going to be watching it on, probably use my phone.
Okay.
It's going to be the best bet. Like I said, we're trying a new setup. We've got the GoPro live streaming tonight. So if you notice any sort of issues, please let us know in the comments. Hopefully it's an improvement over previous live streams. I'm looking at the quality right now, and it's quite good. We got the wide angle. It's
wonderful.
Nice to see. So I see we got Nathan in the comments. Good to see you. Hyundai and Kia is among the top five best car mainstream car brands right now. I agree. So winner Hyundai. What's happening, Alyssa and Charlie from Stacy Flint?
Oh, nice. Hello. Yeah, welcome back.
Yep. Okay, so Alyssa's going to be a mixture of holding the camera and checking comments. So we'll check in periodically. So you should just have to just open it back up, and we should be comments.
Cool.
So just
great.
Whatever you feel like. So let's do a little bit of walk around, and then we're going to get right on the road, drive it around a little bit, listen to the silence of the hybrid, and go from there. So I will take the camera.
Good.
Everyone say hi, Liz.
Hi.
She's got her cute Kate Spade bag tonight.
Wait, no, you can't do that. It's not sponsored.
Ah, well, hey, if Kate Spade wants to sponsor us, I'm totally okay with that. So overall, the hybrid does have a little bit different design elements, just slight. You see this big chrome bar down here. I'm actually not a huge fan of that. I thought the Sonata is a beautifully unique car, mm-hmm. in general, and for them to kind of add that, how did you describe it the other night? Look, something like,
why so serious smile? Because it goes from corner all the way around to this other one, all the way around.
Big wrap.
From eye to eye, from cheek to cheek, it's very Joker-esque.
Yeah, I agree. So it's almost like, yeah, if you were to paint this green. Green on a white,
yeah.
Sonata, or no, it's red. It is,
yeah,
red. So
yeah.
If you were to get a white Sonata and then do the red,
yeah,
of a lipstick or something,
be
a Halloween car.
Yeah, Halloween coming up here. Yeah.
But I've always really liked the headlights in the new Sonata. We'll turn on the LEDs next time we stop, and you'll see how it just kind of goes. It fades from full LED all the way back up there. It looks really, really nice.
And this flowing line is really nice because it starts like at the front headlight. It goes all the way around here, goes over this corner, and comes back down over by that mirror right there. And it's just so sleek and clean. You can tell a person that has real design talent took control of the design aspect of this car, and I love that.
Mm-hmm. Got it here in this bright red paint. And if you look up on top here, you will notice that we have a solar panel on the roof. And this is found on the limited trim of the Sonata Hybrid. And this allows you to get about, at max sunlight, 200 watt hours of power. So that's about 0.2, well, I mean, it is technically 0.2 kilowatt hours. And they assume that the Sonata, I think just cruising around in general, can do about 4 miles per kilowatt hour. So if you were to drive, quick math, 5 hours in full sunlight, you'd get an extra 4 miles of electric driving range thanks to that solar roof. So it's not exactly, it's not gonna completely line your wallet. It's not like you can drive on the power of the sun, but it is kind of cool. A little bit gimmicky, but also a little cool, especially if you lived in a really sunny place out in the desert or something like that.
And are there any other cars that have solar sunroofs?
There have been a few other cars that have solar sunroofs, but not all of them actually can send power from the solar roof to the drive wheels and the drive battery. Some of them are only used to power things like your radio, phone chargers, things like that.
Okay.
Yep. I want to say one of the Priuses had a solar roof, if not the newest Prius Prime. I think it might be the newest Prius. And then the Carmen... No, Fisker Karma, I think, had a solar roof. Someone in the comments can check that for me. Yep. So we've got the back kind of swooping lion design as well. Before we do too much in the interior or in the exterior too much more, let's just get behind the wheels, take it out for a little bit, and go from there. I'll meet you inside.
Okay.
You can at least see the introduction to the nice... How would you describe this color as like commonplace? It's not really chocolate. Kind of peanut butter?
No, not even. It's like a
caramel? It's lighter than caramel.
Like, it's what I imagine
is sand. Like, it's almost like a dark sand.
Yeah, like Sahara caramel sand. I don't know.
Yeah.
Is there a does it say on the
window? Going on in the comment section.
Did you talk about that comment there?
When are Kia and Hyundai going to release their trucks? Oh yeah, probably 2021, either a late 2021 release for the Santa Cruz. I haven't seen any official on Hyundai's truck, or sorry, Kia's truck. But yeah, Hyundai Santa Cruz probably 2021. Yes, the Fisker Karma did have a solar roof. Thanks, Nathan. Okay, so as you see here, 47 mile per gallon average, 45 city, 51 highway. We did run this on our 7 mile per hour highway fuel economy loop today, and I did not quite achieve the 1 mile per gallon mark. It was somewhere down, I think it was 48. Still really good, but not quite a window sticker. In fact, it was our first car to do below the EPA fuel rating, which is not too surprising for a hybrid. For the color, what were we looking on here?
Name of the interior.
Yeah, do you color. See it anywhere? Sometimes they have it up. Oh, well, the outside's tan.
Wow.
Tan.
Okay.
Calypso red is the exterior color, though. And this doesn't tell us the price, but I do know that this model is about $36,000. So not too bad for everything
again.
Actually,
yeah, that's really not bad at all.
Right, yeah. The Maybach 57S had a solar panel. Wow. For just adaptive cruise, is that what you mean? Moran Samandi, good to see you back. Why would they need a solar panel just for adaptive cruise? Actually, I should show this little startup. Greeted with...
I love little shines.
So when it starts in mode. Let's see, we get that little animation. I think they've done a good job at these refresh rates. When I shift up into sport, you can see that sort of that little burst. I bet maybe I can do that. It'll be a little better. So that's when I go to eco. You kind of see the gauges kind of do that little shrink thing, and then poof. Sport mode. Older Hyundais that had that animation, there was a little bit of a lag factor. Yeah. Okay. Shifter is no sort of conventional shifter. It's just buttons. Very easy to operate. Still takes up a lot of space, though, for being buttons. They could be like Lincoln and sort of hide it in here. That'd be nifty, but we just hover away now. I do really appreciate we've got a 360 camera that you can bring up in parking lots. Sort of see as you're pulling up to a curb or something. Also, let us know about the audio. I've got a new, not only are we using the GoPro, but I've got a Media Mod, I think it's called, on the GoPro. So that should allow us to have really good audio from both me and Alyssa. A little bit better than the phone we've been using before.
I can read these.
I do notice for a hybrid, the engine kicks on a little easily. And say the Prius, for example, or a lot of Toyota hybrids, you are able to be really easy on the throttle and get up to speed maybe 25 miles per hour or so before the hybrid battery kicked in, or before the engine kicked in. Not really the case here with the Sonata Hybrid. I do really appreciate this nice high definition energy flow screen. You can see the engine providing power right now to the battery as well as the wheels. You can see we're getting just a little bit of juice from the solar roof as well.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
As we go into this little bit of sun, maybe it'll jump up to 2/3. No, now and then jump up to 3/3, but the fuel economy drive. Mm. Yep, when I was doing that, it would jump up to 3/3 every now and again, but I kept going through so many clouds, it was down to kind of one like
right,
that.
Right.
And any time I went over or under an overpass, it dropped to zero.
Oh,
like,
wow.
It's
okay.
Pretty immediate.
Okay,
yeah.
Wow, that's actually really cool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so it's a pretty live reading there.
Nice. So yep. Then it should be pretty accurate.
In theory. You notice just kind of how well the Sonata, at least here in limited trim, does at road isolation.
Yeah.
You noticed last night that it takes the bumps pretty well.
It
fairly
really
quiet.
Does. And we were going over some really, really bad bumps there.
Yep.
Yeah. Really quiet. And I said it felt like there was a balloon under the wheels.
All right, let's turn that off. Just a little bit of airflow.
And a really nice close look at everything that we have here. One more sweep on the dash.
The navigation looks really good. If I bring up the map. Super high def.
As our zoom rate, it's fairly decent for cars.
I mean, this is as good, if not better, than a system, of a system, than the Lexus IS that we had last week. That was a new system for Lexus.
That's nice.
Updated, at least. I really like the steering wheel that Hyundai's been using. It's kind of it's a four spoke, and they put the spokes sort of right here at, what would this be, about 4:30 and 7:30. That allows a lot of different hand positions. You can do the standard 9 and 3, 10 and two. It's got the little notches right there. You can also sort of just rest one hand on either side and your fingers nicely kind of caress this. It's probably plastic. It could be just like a metal coating. And then you can also still just rest your hand here on the bottom at 6 o'clock.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. In the K900, the Kia K900, they've got the same wheel but with a nice wood grain.
Ooh.
Feels nice. Yep. Feels good in the hands. So what do you guys think about the new Sonata? I know I was talking to a North American Car of the Year juror, and he said it was finalized last year for North American Car of the Year because it truly elevated the sedan class. The sedan class. Made great ride. Is it better than the offers from probably still get a new Fusion, even though they're not building them.
Right. Yeah, it's so crazy about that.
Chevy Malibu. Toyota Camry.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. So what do you guys think? Do you think this really is that much better?
Well, they're actually asking us.
Okay.
So interior quality, we'll talk about that. What I love about new cars is the, what is this called again? I can't think of it.
Wireless charger.
Yes, a wireless charger right here. Look at all of the space that you have inside here. And this is usually something that they put maybe a little pocket of some sort, and they always have, you know, your voltage right there. So it's, there are some cars that this space right here is so limited. So to have an actual wireless charger here, some additional space over here, all of your charging needs right there, and then it's just these small little things. I really like that. They even have like a little phone stand in between your cup holders. I've never seen that. And that's just so silly and just small, but I see that, I'm like, that's actually really cool. No one else is really doing that.
Mm-hmm.
We, of course, have all of this space in here. The materials, I think, are very high quality. We have this beautiful, soft, supple, tan leather here, and it's all in the seats. We have the perforated seats in here, and it's the same color all throughout, very unified. I like the
color scheme that they went with. We have like the softer kind of off-white tan color up
beige,
here. It's a good beige, yeah. It's a good soft color, easy on the eyes. It's up here. Of course, you've got blacks and grays and chromes, and then they throw the tan in here, so it looks really clean and professional. You would imagine that some person higher up in the ranks, some professional, would be driving this kind of car. That's the feel that you get from this executive.
Right. Even though it's not
a word that, yeah,
like not a crazy expensive car. I mean, the base hybrid starts at like $26,000.
Yeah.
That one gets over 50 miles to the gallon according to the EPA. And then this one at 36.
Yeah.
Very, very nice.
Yeah, it's very affordable. So you don't have to break the bank in order to feel like you're driving something that is high quality.
Right. And that kind of leads into the comment that Nathan started with at the beginning. Hyundai and Kia, I mean, all of their new products are pushing that sort of like common luxury stats that tell you ride you haven't been in yet, but you were in Hyundai a year ago.
Yeah.
And just, yeah, that's a Hyundai. And yet, and it was all
yeah,
these great features, the like quilted leather seats.
Captain speaking.
Yep. So,
yeah, that was a very nice, very large car.
Right. So they're doing so many things to just make themselves stand out as
yeah,
a brand, and I say they, Hyundai and Kia together, technically they are different brands, but
right,
all in the same parent company, so.
Right. Ooh, we're getting some sun here.
Yeah.
When we do get the sun, we complain about it. We do have these extendos on our,
yes,
yeah, these
extendos
are
extendos and handles.
Yep.
It's a double win.
Yeah, that's pretty nice actually. So, mm-hmm, yeah, very clean on the inside, very nice. The lines are very sleek.
Mm-hmm.
Do a nice pan of the cabin here.
It's a car yeah, that you can feel happy and satisfied with driving and owning, but then also just kind of have it fade into the background when you need it to.
Absolutely, yeah. And it looks very striking on the outside, so I wouldn't ever think that, you know, that would go away. You'd still look at it and just be like, wow, that is an interesting, striking, very cool car.
Right.
Yeah.
Yep, I totally agree. I'm trying to think of good places with shade around here. I suppose we can go mm-hmm, back to our usual parking lot. Oh, actually, this might work right over here.
Oh, sweet. We've got Kyle and Wide Putin watching. Hey, guys.
Wow, we got all of our OGs. Everyone's probably tuning in so that they can check out the debate later tonight. So
oh, yeah.
Everyone's already sitting on the TV.
Yeah.
Or on the computer.
The gang's all here. By the way, guys, just heads up with the debate coming in later. Let's try to just only talk about cars tonight and leave the debates for later.
We can debate Hyundai Kia topics, though. I want to show you in here in the gauge cluster. Maybe it'd be best if I turn this around. Let's see. Turning radius, decent. Now, for those of you who did not hear earlier, we're doing a new live streaming setup. And part of that is using the GoPro. And another part of that is having a 30-second delay between the video and the comments. So if you're saying anything and we're not getting back to you, don't take it personally, just because there's a delay.
Yep.
So everything we're doing is at least 30 seconds ahead of what you guys are seeing. So right here in the gauge cluster, there's still a good amount of glare, but I think you should be able to see it okay. Oh, another thing I can do, put the steering wheel closer. This is such a cool feature, and I can't wait for more and more cars to get this sort of thing. When you turn the blinker on, it shows you a blind spot camera right there. So let's.
Oh my gosh! You want me to get out?
Just stick your hand like right under the rearview mirror, outside mirror.
Ah, cool.
Yep. So you can see that, and then if you go the other way, pops up on the other side.
That's amazing.
Yeah. So and it's still important to check your mirror and to look back, but to just be able to be driving on the highway and just kind of do a quick glance, like, oh, okay, you know, right there, see that it's clear, still go. And You can see it still shows you your speed right there digitally, because typically this is big speed readout. And on the other side, this is, it's kind of silly actually, because it's not actually an RPM gauge on this side. It's like a power gauge, but when you turn that on, it shows you your RPMs. Pretty cool. All right, let's actually turn the car off, even though the engine's not running. What's going on in the comments? Am I missing anything?
Moran Samadhi wants to know, Mazda 6 Signature.
Oh, that's the one I was forgetting. Mazda 6.
Or the Sonata. Oh, he doesn't. Oh, he was helping you out. I see.
Gotcha. No, yeah. No, he's probably asking. I would say the Mazda 6 is pretty. Mazda 6 drives well. Mazda 6 has a very nice interior, but it's missing some key features. Like, I don't think it has wireless charging. The interior is just not quite as well laid out as it is here in the Sonata. Mm-hmm. And I appreciate that the Mazda 6, people see it and they're just kind of like, oh, that's a handsome car. That's nice. Especially if you get it in Soul Red Crystal. But the Sonata, people see it and they're like, that's cool. Like, that's different. That's exciting. So if I lived somewhere with good roads and like maybe up in the mountains or something like that, and I didn't have another, like, motorcycles or like a fun weekend car or something, I would consider the Mazda. But other than that, for just daily driving and efficiency and everything, right here,
right,
Sonata over the Mazda. Plus, Mazda 6 doesn't have a hybrid option.
That's right. And that's what you really like.
Right. I like getting that efficiency. Mm-hmm.
White Putin says, Hyundai has done some shady business in the past, which gives them a bad taste, so especially with some of their hybrids.
Yeah, but so has FCA, so has Volkswagen, and you know, when we're talking just like EPA stuff in general. Ford, I mean, all the manufacturers are out there trying to compete, and Hyundai, with some of their EPA stuff, I don't think that's as bad as some of the other manufacturers out there. I think they're doing their best.
Well, you're right. That's good.
Not that I'm a total, you know, Hyundai sympathizer. It's just, I just think it's kind of, you don't hate the players, hate the game sort of deal.
That's a good point.
Right.
So are we going to allow an inappropriate joke from Wide Putin or no?
I'll let you be the determiner, and if it's...
What? No! Okay, let us know if it's inappropriate.
Would you say it in front of a high school teacher?
There you go.
Yeah. Then again, we're not, this stream isn't monetized. So, I mean, I guess other than us wanting to keep it family friendly, there's nothing we're missing out on.
Right.
Let's go in the back. There you go. There's your inappropriate joke. Back here, really good amount of legroom for a family sedan. I think, at least.
On first glance, I'm thinking, like, really is my seat that far back?
But, well, yeah, I guess you had a lot of room up front.
Yeah, I do, actually. But again, I don't have any issues.
You still get the same sort of swooping, big grab point center or side armrest in the back. That's kind of neat. That's the same up in the front. Also, I kind of noticed that this part right here sort of mimics the outside, how it sort of swoops.
I really like that a lot.
There's a lot of cohesion in the design of this car.
We do have the sun blockers.
Yeah, and
really
that's
great.
That's cool to see in a sedan. You often get those on new, like, luxury SUVs and things like that, but not sedans.
Mm-hmm. Although I think
especially
it's making a rattle.
There have been a few rattles inside this car that have bothered me. One was coming from the head-up display up front. So.
But if you have, unless you have ears like a hawk, like Charlie, and care about that kind of thing, don't worry about it.
I don't think I'm the only one. Okay. Chris mentions them too. USB power point back here. You can kind of tell that used to be like where a 12 volt would go, and they just kind of retrofitted it for USB. Center armrest.
Yep.
That's
a cool thing. I think it's just a...
Oh, it's to keep it from rattling, probably. Nice little soft point.
Okay, yeah. So they care.
These are hard. No sort of grippies in there.
Yeah.
But not the end of the world.
No, that's fine. Is that your 32 answer?
No.
White Putin says he would say it in front of a teacher.
Okay, well then let's hear it.
Yeah.
Why not?
Look forward to it.
Just one big light, no individual reading lights back here. So, I mean, little things like that, you can have a well-designed car that's not a luxury car. I mean, just because there are good materials And it's nice looking in here. Yeah. Doesn't mean it has necessarily everything to make it a luxury vehicle. I mean, you don't have individual reading lights. You don't have the back screen guard or, you know, like shade to come up.
Right.
But I think for the price point and for the class, they've really checked all the boxes. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. However, this Bose sound system is not very great. I was listening to it on the drive, the fuel economy drive, and I could not find a good setting for it. It's frustrating. It's 12 speakers, and Bose usually does pretty decent. Not happening.
Hmm.
Yeah.
12 speakers, really?
12, yeah, we got one down the door, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12.
Wow.
Yep.
12, and they still couldn't do it.
I know. Oh. It's not the number of speakers, it's how well you tune them.
Hmm. We should remember that.
Yep. All right. What's the joke? Is it still coming?
We're waiting on it. Come on, man. We're waiting on your joke.
Oh, I suppose it took 30 seconds from him saying that for him to hear it from us. So, okay. Liz, you want to come take the camera and I will look into seat folding?
Yeah.
Okay. So, to fold the seats here in the Sonata, I think you got to come to the back. Now this is super neat. The first time I saw this, I just thought it was so cool. Let's go ahead and open the trunk.
Open the trunk, huh?
Yep.
Okay, I'm looking for a button of some kind. No, okay, it's not that cool. What? Is it in one of the letters? It's like so clean back here. I have no idea. That's the camera, so it's not that.
All right, you ready?
What?
Isn't that awesome?
I put my entire hand on it.
Oh, yeah, it's okay. So nifty. Just go ahead.
Yeah, that is.
Like
that. Oh, yeah, it goes. I'm gonna do it again. All right, you can actually feel, it feels like a button, like right here, right in that spot. You press it and even the paint goes down. That's actually really neat. I like that a lot.
Yeah, I do too.
Yep. It's almost like the new Volkswagens with the, flip the logo. Mm-hmm. I thought it was going to be something like that.
Nope. Not quite that new.
Cooler, actually.
Pull those. Fold the seats.
There's actually a lot of decent space back here, too.
Then.
I'll stay back here. There we go.
Down you go. Very standard sedan opening here. Doesn't smell great. Maybe it's some sort of cleaner they've been using.
Yeah, potentially. Or it could be all the mechanicals that we can actually see right from here.
Yeah, it could be that as well. But yeah, you can fold the seats, just standard 60-40 split.
I'll wait till Charlie comes back because I don't know what any of this. Oh, there it is.
So you got a spare. Just a little compact.
Yep.
Got your tools right up on top.
It always amazes me that you can see like the metal body right there that's got some paint on it. Yeah.
It's just right there, that's it.
Is it metal?
Yeah, that's the frame.
Yeah.
You know, okay. The body and everything. Catching a bit wide, Putin. He had to go. I guess we gotta wait to hear the joke. Yeah, he said he'll be back. No sort of grocery bag hooks or anything back here, so that's a bit of a bummer.
Yeah, this is really pretty standard. There is a little handle thingy right here that I don't know what that does. Do you know anything about this?
It's probably just like there's sometimes fuse boxes or just like little things for the speakers or something.
Got it.
Right. But yeah, the back looks good.
Oh, you already did it.
I'll turn the quick side note. I've always liked the hybrid logos on Hyundai. It's like just a cool thing. I'll turn the lights on.
Aerial.
They on now?
Yeah. This GoPro is picking them up as like super flashy, but obviously they're not doing that.
Yeah, that's just kind of a refresh rate thing.
Oh, it looks really cool. But it goes all the way across here. Are they on in the front too?
Yep. Yeah, let's go ahead and see the LEDs in the front.
Yeah, the LEDs look really great. Although I don't know if you're going to be able to see it in this lighting.
Yeah, by the end of the live stream, 7 o'clock, we should be able to see it even better. But yeah, I mean, you can see it's full brightness here and then sort of fades.
Yeah, it really does. Let me zoom in for you guys. That might be seizure and friendly, but.
All right, we'll so for any later. Of you just tuning in, this is a live drive of the 2020 Hyundai Sonata. We're driving it around, answering your questions, answering questions about anything else we got going on. We'll probably keep going for about another half hour, so talk a little bit more about the car and then also talk about some of the exciting things we have coming up on the channel in the next few weeks. Mm-hmm. Why do streams take so long to upload? Oh, this is my first video ever. Sometimes streams are weird, Kyle. Facebook has a whole different setup for those. They can definitely be finicky. All right, let's get back behind the wheel.
Alrighty.
Those panels in the back go to the taillights. Ah, yes, so if you needed to replace
a
taillight bulb back there.
Obviously.
Thanks, Nathan. Why the sound systems of Bose is bad? All cars come with good audio systems. I mean, it's like, I haven't fully tested the Bose audio system in here, but I'd probably be giving it like a 6, which is disappointing for this car, for having it do so many good things. Right. I do have some seat memory over here, which is nice. I do really, really like the way the climate control is set up also here in the Sonata. You've got these big old knobs for changing temperature on both the driver and passenger side, and it shows you right in the middle the temperature. And then when you want to use auto, you can press it here, but there's actually 3 levels of auto. See that little? So it's nice because this level, let's turn it to like 72, lower fan speed, high fan speed, medium fan speed. So when you have it on low, the fan will never get that loud, even when it needs to like rush. I mean, let's see. So in this case, low with 3 is probably gonna give us max fan. You can see up here, it's at all the way up. But if I switch down to low auto, fans actually slow down.
Yep. Wow.
Yeah, and I really appreciate that because I don't like high fan speeds.
No, and you don't like how they sound either.
Right.
Even though it's actually at the bottom, you just turn it off.
Yeah.
But even though it was actually at the lowest auto setting, it was still at mid fan speed.
Right, because it needs to work
something.
To get down
yeah.
to low. I mean, low is low, very low. But yeah, just very easy to use, very straightforward buttons, and there's some of the most clever heated and cooled seat design.
Huh.
Press up for seat heat, and down for cool.
Yeah,
so you start in the middle,
neat.
And then bloop, bloop, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. All right. Put GPS to Portugal.
Why? are you Portuguese?
Let's just see what would happen. we'll try it with the voice.
Please say a command.
Navigate to Lisbon, Portugal.
No matched result found. Please say
what?
The POI name or address you want to find.
Let's try doing it manually. I doubt it's going to work. But, you know, we'll humor you guys. We're here to have fun. we like thinking of things or, you know, getting suggestions we wouldn't think of.
That's actually really cool. Oh, it doesn't even go outside of the U.S.
It doesn't acknowledge the fact that there are other
countries.
It's just North America.
So sorry.
No Portugal.
America is all that matters.
Apple CarPlay and auto and Android Auto support, you bet. I can actually demo that because it looks pretty. Oh no, I can't. I didn't bring my cable.
That was something we were supposed
time.
To remember.
Yeah, in the review, we can demo that. I need to start bringing a cable. Top 3 sound systems I've reviewed. Mark Levinson in the GX460. What else? Bang & Olufsen. Is it Bang & Olufsen? I think it's. I'm drawing a blank, but whatever one was in the Mercedes-Benz GLS 580, that one, I think it was the Bowers & Wilkins. No, I think it's actually, I don't know.
Are you doing okay?
I get confused between Bang & Olufsen and Bowers & Wilkins. What's the third one? The Volvo
Carmen?
Systems are really good.
The Carmen Harnon? Harman?
No, the
really?
The Volvo's Bowers & Wilkins, probably okay. The other third best, yeah. Hey, buy an airplane. That it's me.
Okay.
Okay, so we can get to Portugal. All right. Hovering away.
I do love that. Hybridness, the electricness of this car. It's really nice. I like the sound that it makes. It sounds so...
futuristic.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah. We'll play the reverse sound a little clearer later. Mm-hmm. All right, well, let's try out the sport mode a little bit here. So Alyssa and I just had the rip-snorting Avalon TRD last weekend. So anything else is going to seem mundane, but let's just lean into it. So you could feel an initial surge right there when the battery power was working.
Yeah.
And then the engine finally kicked into pull. Plenty fast enough for your day-to-day driving, though.
Absolutely, yeah.
Steering is definitely not as good as a Mazda. Is it a Corvette up here? It is. Nice
C7. I'm gonna be like, nope.
Okay. Should we race him?
I mean, is that Kia gonna leave? Kia's kind of in the way.
We're beating the Corvette. We're going faster.
Come up here. Oh.
I wonder if they're together. Looks like someone's a little lost. Should we like blow by him here?
Sure. And our electricness.
Meow.
Bye. Oh. That pump made the GoPro hit the visor here.
Look at that plane.
Sunroof. I actually couldn't see it from over here.
Because you got a solar roof.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a sunroof in a way.
Yeah, you're right. It is a roof for the sun.
Yes.
Do you have paddle shifters?
Oh, cool.
Oh, that is a policeman.
Where?
Right there.
Oh.
Good to know. The police do not typically hang out around here.
Oh, actually.
Camera a little bit lower, Ben.
Oh.
They're radaring, too. Huh. Unless they're, like, looking for someone in particular.
I was gonna say, the sun is out, but we still only have, like, two notches here.
Yeah.
On the battery thing.
Because it's such, like, a low angle. Yeah, now the hybrid roof, like I said, in most people's use case, it's probably just gonna be a bit gimmicky. But
it's gonna be gimmicky because it's like kind of the first concept of it actually having a purpose and utilizing that purpose. If it only is, you know, just a little bit of a purpose and still kind of buggy.
You're right.
So it's the start of something that we're most likely gonna see probably in the next 10 years or so.
Maybe as solar panels get more efficient.
Right.
And yeah, especially if you parked outside, then it would be nice for you to
always
come out to a fuller battery.
Yeah.
Yeah, the steering isn't Mazda good. The car itself, in terms of sporty driving, obviously this is a hybrid, but I've driven the standard gas one as well. It's no Accord and it's no Mazda 6. Those two cars are still better driver's cars. But I think this is a more compelling, holistic package. Now, the Accord Hybrid is very good, too. Not quite as efficient as this, and a little more stale, that's for sure. The other one that I have not driven yet, and I've kind of not mentioned it because of it, is the new Kia K5, which was the Kia Optima that they've renamed for its international version, the K5. And that one should be very good, but it should be pretty similar to this, because they're the same platform.
Is it going to have a solar roof?
I don't know. I'm sure they're doing a hybrid, but I'm not sure. Hyundai is a little more on the hybrid game than Kia is. Yeah, Kia's a little more sporty. Hyundai's a little more efficient. Hyundai's got the Ioniq lineup. Kia doesn't. They're just like, nah.
Oh, I completely forgot about comments.
Yeah, we'll check them periodically. Like now.
Ooh, does the audio include a subwoofer setting to set up the audio level?
No, you can do I'll show you. slide over here to set up. So, tone down here. You've just got bass, mid-range, and treble. No subwoofer. The car doesn't have a subwoofer. It has some decent bass speakers in the back, but there's no actual subwoofer. So, just bass, mid-range, and treble. Another thing with the sound system. Well, I can answer a few more chats. Are there more to?
Moran Samandi wants you to see if it will hold the gear to redline.
We'll do that in a minute, but I'm pretty sure it does not. It shifts for you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it doesn't hold gears.
Okay.
No rev limiters on this one. Mm. Anything else?
He also said it was a Burmaster.
The Burmeister. Okay. In the GLS.
Yeah,
that makes sense. Okay. I knew it was something with a B. Okay, so this is kind of neat. And also goofy. It's a Hyundai thing. Go home. If Nathan's still watching, he knows how ridiculous this is. There's your Android Auto and Apple CarPlay right there. Sounds of Nature.
What?
Does it sound like a lively forest in here? Kyle, are you still watching? Does it sound like a lively forest? What about calm sea waves?
That would just be torture if you are on a car ride and whoever has control of the cabin just turns that on and makes everyone in the car feel like they have to pee.
No, that would be this one.
That's worse!
This is a rainy day. Then you have, they keep getting sillier. I'm gonna just jump to warm fireplace, because that's kind of cool.
That actually would be super nice if you're driving in a blizzard, snowstorm, or if it's just winter.
Probably would not be great to have in California right now, though.
A little
distasteful, Hyundai.
A little too soon. Distasteful for you.
Hyundai's the one who made it. There, you go back to your open-air cafe. I like to just picture the image of like just someone from Hyundai just sitting there with like a microphone in the cafe.
Yeah.
But then by far, the silliest one, they always get louder too.
Yeah.
Like crescendo, it's kind of annoying. By far the funniest is Snowy Village.
Oh, I like this one.
I want to know where they shot this. How loud can it go?
Stop! It's pending!
They're getting closer. I think in a second there's a kid that like laughs, like a baby.
A what?
Yeah. Just wait. How creepy is that?
Oh my god!
Can you imagine?
They could have had like a little kid like do a chuckle, but like have a Chucky sound. Oh my goodness.
Imagine if you were sleeping in the car on like a road trip and someone turned this on and just slowly turned the volume up. You'd be like, what is going on?
Yes! The crunching, that it's normally like a very satisfying crunch when you step on snow, kind of like dead leaves.
Yeah, dead leaves actually would have been like crunchy crunch leaves would have been really cool.
But the crunch is almost too much. It's like it doesn't let up, you know?
Yeah. Right. And there's like a background wind noise too that makes it like more ominous. Anyway, those are pretty silly. I want to see what people have to say about that.
That's such an odd feature by Stacy Clinton.
Right?
You are right, to say the least. Nachito L wants to know, does the car have HD radio and Sirius XM?
It sure does. Right here, you got your radio. Got my public radio because I'm classy like that. You have your HD radio right there. You can toggle that in high definition. For those of you who don't know, it's gaining the HD signal.
Ah.
For those of you who don't know, HD radio typically actually sounds better than Sirius XM satellite radio. because it actually streams at a higher band rate. But you do have your Sirius XM.
Some hurricanes that are watching, but nothing.
Looks like someone was listening to traffic.
Affecting the U.S. mainland.
Yeah. Traffic and weather. And you got AM, obviously. Anything else interesting in here? HD radio data. Oh, I should go to media.
Get out of that.
Yeah, outside of your sounds of nature, you've also got... Oh, maybe I can't... Oh, media sources. Here we go. You have USB, Bluetooth, Apple CarPlay, and Android Auto. Yep.
Nice.
So you can see I've got my USB stick in here now. This is how we do the sound system tests. So for those of you who listen to our sound system tests regularly, you know I have the standard 7 tracks that I use, but I also have a ton of other uncompressed lossless music in different genres and stuff that I listen to sort of test it in other ways. And I can't play these songs because I'll get demonetized on a standard video, on a sound test video. But just letting you know, it's not just those 7 songs. I like, where is albums? Now I gotta go files. I got a Rush album for those of you who like Rush. And I think I really like turning on this one. Just really gives like a good holistic, like around the car, different sounds. I'll tell you, this car really needs a subwoofer though. There's no power to the music. It's all very mid and high. The mids are very echoey and sort of hollow sounding. So pretty frustrating. Yeah, other than that, I kind of got this 3 things set up, and that's the infotainment.
Nice.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Would you like to drive?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll take a first spin.
All right. I will set my seat. Settings 1 saved. Thank you for the confirmation. Turn the car off so Alyssa can get the full effect. Pop the hood.
Oh, you want to look at it?
Yeah, I'll do a quick look before you start. Hood struts, that's nice. You don't have to put the little thing in there. Pretty compact. You got your 4-cylinder, little plastic over, and then all of your hybrid gear. Yep. And this is pretty interesting. Look at the oil weight. 0W16 oil. Most cars have like 0W10 or 0W30 or 0W40, but 16, very, very random oil weight there.
Okay.
So it's probably very specific for the hybrid motor. Keep that in mind if you're changing oil on a Sonata Hybrid. Yeah.
Cool.
Cool. All right. I think it's cool that you can see the lines just like right outside of the hood too. Just good. Just well designed.
Yeah, really is.
Yeah. Well, Alyssa's got a bunch of seat adjustments over there to get comfortable with.
No height. Oh, I do have height. The passenger does not have height.
Right.
I need to get my,
Amy Dreyer said, Snowy Village equals last scene in The Shining.
That is great. Yes, I like that.
Nachito voice memo, you can actually just make a voice memo. I'll open it up here once we get driving and say you're driving and, you had a new $1 million idea and you weren't able to pull over and write it down. You can just take a voice memo.
Nice. Very nice. Cool. I feel like my seat adjustment is already like set. That's probably the easiest I've been able to adjust my seat in one of these cars. So, cool.
Cool.
Mm-hmm.
Well.
Ooh, fun fact. My ex drove a Sonata. So,
Probably wasn't a nice 2020 hybrid though.
It's not. Oh, there is
upgrade.
A light up.
Yep. Yeah, I should see if that pops up here.
Let me take it.
Might just not show
it
up.
It does not, but it's... Oh, wait. It's actually really very
just faint.
Small. It's right there in case you guys...
Nice head-up display.
Yeah. Ooh, the wheel. That was just so easy.
Okay, you can use this to see if you're going to hit the curb. So you
should
can
we keep going?
Well, crank the wheel, and then you see it actually shows you where your
That's
wheel would
really
end
cool.
up. So Alyssa can tell she is going to hit the curb, so you'll have to back up.
Cool.
And then it switches over to backup mode, and you still got the little 360 deal. Oh yeah, it makes a noise hybrid. Can you guys, here, wait, go back in reverse. I'm gonna put the camera out and see if you can hear it. In fact, I'll just get out. Just do a little like 10-foot backup or so. So you guys can hear, it's beeping at me. Comes out of the front. It's sort of like an ominous warning sound. Yeah, it's like a classy utility vehicle. And that's just because...
I don't like that.
Well, some manufacturers find it necessary, since the car's silent on electric.
That makes sense.
To alert people if you're backing up or something.
That makes sense. I don't want to drive like a super nice classy car and then have it make backup beeping sounds like a giant, you know, one of those utility vans.
Right.
Ford makes. I don't want that.
Yeah, and I don't think it's a government mandate because I don't think... I'm pretty sure Tesla doesn't have it, so unless Tesla's just breaking the law, which is highly possible.
I love the steering wheel. It's so light. Mm. It's ridiculous. I love it. I need to go up a little bit.
Yes, thanks for coming in. No worries about being late, but miles per gallon on this hybrid model, 45 city, 51 highway, and 47 combined. However, on our real world 70 mile per hour highway test, we only managed 48 miles per gallon. Still very good for the car, but not quite its EPA rating. For anyone just tuning in, we are out here in the Sonata Hybrid answering your chats. Alyssa's taking her first time behind the wheel, kind of seeing what she thinks about it. In fact, this might be, is this your first time driving just a standard hybrid? I know you've driven plug-in hybrids and EVs.
It might be. Gonna come over this garbage here in the road. Should I take a right or go
straight? Go straight and then go left. Yeah.
Wait, after this little guy?
Stacy agrees with your sentiments on the beeping.
I mean, you're not spending a ton of money on it, but it is still a nice chunk of change that you're letting go because you want this car. You wouldn't want to sound like, you know, right. People hear the backup and be like, is this just some, you know, blue collar worker or whatever, so.
Maran, I don't know if it has a variable steering ratio. Maybe if I got behind the wheel again, I could sort of tell you, but it's electronic power steering, so probably. The steering was pretty light in the parking lot.
It's really light steering. It's very nice. I like it a lot. Yep. This is such an easy car to drive. I just got in it. I feel like I've been driving it for 5 years. This is so... I haven't even owned a car for more than 3 years. I like it a lot. It's very easy, very nice.
You're right. There's not really any sort of, admissions you have to make. Like, oh, the braking is kind of weird. Or, oh, yeah. The steering is kind of weird. Or the seating is kind of weird. Like, everything fits. Everything works really
it's
well.
It's so user-friendly.
Yep.
The iPhone of cars. At least one of them.
Feel free to kind of go wherever you want. And just.
That's pretty much what I'm doing. Okay. Cool.
So other things we have going on in the channel, we have a pretty exciting week coming up. I think it's the week of the 11th, 12th range. We are getting another Corvette. We're getting a Z51 3LT C8 in Accelerate yellow, very bright and flashy. So that'll be cool. We're going to take that out to the track along with a brand new 2020 Mustang GT350R Heritage Edition. If you don't know what that is, look it up. It's the same color scheme as the old GT350 from the 60s, straight from Shelby. It looks amazing. It's gonna be awesome to drive. We're gonna have both of them out at Gingerman Raceway in South Haven, Michigan. Chris from the Topher and I are gonna have a ton of fun. Alyssa's gonna come out. We'll throw her on the back a little bit. Same with the Civic car. Unfortunately, the Civic can't make it out to the track because Honda doesn't have any extra brakes for it.
And it's gonna need it for that.
Right, exactly. However, last time we were out at this track day, there was a new Civic Type R and it overheated. So, not great the prospects for that. What else? We've got a Hyundai Ioniq Electric coming in a few weeks. I'm excited about that one because I like EVs. new Lincoln Navigator. Hopefully, I think it's got the big Revel system, so I'll test the sound system on that one. But Alyssa and I will be towing a race car out with that Navigator. That'll be good. Honda Ridgeline is up at Chris's starting tomorrow.
Is that comp is still there?
No, he would have been back there. Must have gone and done something else.
Oh, good.
See how it does around these. Oh, Toyota Supra coming next week. Supra 3-liter. Haven't driven the 2-liter Supra yet, but I have driven the 3 a bunch, and it's really good, a lot of fun, so that'll be a cool one to have around. Oh, this is putting me through the treatment.
Yep. About time. You always do that to me.
Let's give you sport mode here. Does it include that you have to get out and the car will automatically park if you have no space? Yes. This Sonata does have the smart park feature. In fact, I should check the key. Let me see here. Maybe it doesn't actually, because I think you have to have. Doesn't it have to have the little special smart park button on the key? That's kind of sad. I don't know if I ever showed you that with the last Sonata. You really liking that,
I love it. Look at it. I'll just do it right now. It's right there.
Yep.
It's really awesome.
So no, maybe this one doesn't have smart park. I don't know why they didn't include that on the hybrid. Unless I'm just forgetting something. But yeah, definitely a big win for Hyundai here. One of my favorite cars.
Huge win.
For 2020.
I love this car.
Yeah. My GT350 misses the R and Heritage badge. Well, hey, Maran Samandi, any GT350 is a car worth having. I love that car so much. It's been about a year since I've driven one, so I'm really happy that I'm getting into another one. Definitely on my short list of favorite vehicles on the market right now. And I've never driven the R, so it'll be cool to have that, especially in a track setting.
Over a bunch of big bumps, so we'll see how that goes.
Yeah, not that you guys can feel what we're feeling, but this is a pretty bumpy section. But it's not at this point. It's pretty well. Take it past 7 o'clock here. Yep. Oh yeah, we've got a big whooper bump coming up.
Right. Go in this parking lot over here.
Yeah, you can just make it back to the main parking lot.
Okay.
Yep.
Gonna go fast for this.
Oh. Boom. The stabilization on the GoPro probably doesn't really translate the amount of bump that we get anymore, but we can tell you. It's pretty good. One last little blast of sun. Yeah, we're gonna get wrapping things up, so any last thoughts or comments on the new Sonata? Anything you'd like to know, let us know. Let me know if there's anything different you'd like me to do with the Corvette when we have it as well. Because we already had a C8. I'm thinking I might do a highway fuel economy test, but leave it in sport mode so that it can't do cylinder deactivation. So it just drives in V8 mode the whole time. Because some people said they don't want to have cylinder deactivation. And I understand that because it can mess with the engine's longevity. So I might do that with the car. We're going to have a track video.
The track video will be so cool because you weren't able to do that with the last one.
No, and it's good we got the Z51 package.
Yeah.
Oh man, you've got a twin turbo. Ron Samandi, if you... Sometime you'll have to hit me up on Instagram or something and we'll have to meet up and do a review on your car. Because if you have a twin turbo Shelby, I'm...
wow.
You're definitely someone that I'd like to see.
Like
can you do a 2020 Honda Odyssey Elite on the live drive? Well, the 2021 is already out. We've reviewed that car briefly. Yes. But we will be getting one back later on this year, and I'm happy to do a live drive on an Odyssey. There'd be tons to talk about in that car. The bigger the car, the more there is to talk about.
That was Charlie, not the tires.
Your view and the Topher. Ooh, Stacy Flint got a 2020 Pro 4X Titan. Good to know. Hey, you know, the Titan is a really good truck. I know everyone in the comments loves to bash on mine and Nathan's review of the Tundra and the Titan, the comparison. We liked both of the trucks. We just thought that the Tundra was a more emotional kind of speak to you as a driver sort of vehicle, but the Nissan was very good. So congratulations on picking that up. I'll be interested to kind of hear how you like it.
Yeah, Is it this one?
Yes. Turn right here. Yep.
Maybe it's on the outside.
Oh. Oh, okay, I think we're back. Looks like we are back. I'm gonna chat real quick. Sorry for the hotspot dropping out there real quick, guys. We are back here. Where can I follow you on what social media? Nachito, we've got Instagram, The Daily Motor. Not as active on it as I should be, as we should be, but you can follow us there. We post a bit, and you can certainly hit us up in the DMs. So let's park this bad nasty, get out, take one final look, and wrap up the stream.
Cool. Do you want it on or off?
Let's turn it off.
Yep. Well, what about the lights?
Oh, well, we can have the lights on with the car off. So go ahead, press it, and then...
it's moving me.
Go ahead and press it one more time now.
This?
Yep. Okay, let's hop out.
Cool.
One last look with the LEDs on, the LEDs. There we go. Now you can see pretty well. Yeah, yeah, hush. Mad because I got out of the car with the key in my pocket. So you see...
That is so nice.
There's a little bit of the flashing going on, but up here, complete just shiny chrome. And then as you come down, it turns into bright light.
That's really neat.
Mm-hmm.
That's really cool. Yep. I like that a lot.
Like this car, eh?
I do. I had 36,000 lying around, and I don't know what I do with it other than buy this.
Stacy, you went from a 2017 Civic to a Tundra, a Titan.
Yeah.
What prompted prompted the big change in vehicle? Did you just want a truck, or are you needing a truck?
What are you hauling?
Right. We will wait for Stacy's response and then we will wrap it up. So any last comments on the Sonata, let us know.
Speak now or forever hold your peace.
Correct. Next week we will be live driving probably the Supra, to be honest.
That's awesome.
I think we're also, is it Supra and Chevy Trailblazer?
You're the scheduler.
I think we're also getting a Chevy Trailblazer, and let's just say the Supra would be a lot more exciting. However, the Trailblazer is brand spanking new. Maybe we'll do both. Maybe we'll do a twofer.
Man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
It'll be a transition from small sporty car to, what is that, a big truck?
No, it's a small SUV. It's small. It's larger than the Chevy Trax, smaller than the Equinox. So, and you know how I feel about both the Trax and the Equinox. So I'm sure going to love the Trailblazer.
Yeah.
Okay, well, we'll get wrapping things up here. Is my shoe untied? My shoe's untied. Oh, no. I guess I'll let you take this. I'll tie my shoe.
I'm just going to ignore Charlie while he ties his shoe.
Thanks for tuning in, everybody. We love doing these live drives. We love getting a chance to talk to you. Thanks for being super active in the chat. Anything you guys want to see on these on this car, let us know in any of the video comments. I do read just about, I try to go through at least once a week and read all the comments on the channel. However, for those of you who may have not noticed, we had a huge breakout week with our Lexus IS 350 review. We're talking like 10 times the numbers we've ever had before. So really exciting to see that happen. Thank you all who are new subscribers to the channel. Thank you all who have been hanging out with us for a long time, the OGs. and thanks to Alyssa for getting to ride this exciting train, and Nathan at Daily Motor as well. All the exciting stuff. Chris up at the Topher. As we get rolling on.